Hello and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to Horse of the Year show. It is 5 a.m, hence why I'm in my car and it's pitch black outside. I am going to drive to meet Danielle, who has been featured in one of my other vlogs, and we're going to Horse of the Year show. So we are super excited about this, but it's going to be a long day. So I best get the ponies done and head over to the town to meet Danielle. So for a change, the boys were actually right at the bottom of the field. They were having a sleep, so I've had to come all the way down to the bottom to feed them. Oh, is it too bright? Oh, I'm sorry, baby. Oh, I'm sorry. Cameras are too bright on his little eyes. He's like, I've just woke up, mummy. Oh, baby, I'm sorry. Is it too early? Is it too early? Oh, bless you. I'm sorry, but he's just so cute. Oh, my little sleepy head. Finley's like, yeah, I don't care, just feed me. Right, a quick feed stop and then we'll be back on the road. We're driving an hour to Danielle's and then we'll be doing another 2 hours roughly to get to the NEC at Birmingham for Horse of the Year show. So me and Danielle are now on our way to Horse of the Year show. Like I said earlier, you might have seen Danielle in one of my hacking vlogs. She owns a lovely little corgi called Wallace, who you brought in March. Yeah, and he was a bit of a project really, because you couldn't even get on him when you brought him. He had like a bit of a mounting issue, didn't he?
Absolutely.
And he hadn't done anything like ever. Just been ragged around at school a couple of times, and yeah, and he is super cute. And the next jumping project, I think.
Oh yeah.
Yes. Yeah, so he'll be at HOYS next year, jumping around the 1m20. But we came here last year just to shop, didn't we? And you didn't have a horse at that time, so it was just buying like clothes and things. And this year you have a pony. That needs a whole new wardrobe, obviously. So we're really looking forward to doing some shopping, maybe watch some jumping, and also the showing, of course, the boring stuff. The coloured class is on today, by the way. Ooh. So maybe check out the competition for next year with Wallace as well. So we have now got a 2 hour journey, I think, according to the sat-nav man, who you can hear talking in the background. And we'll hopefully get there roughly when the shops open and start with some shopping. So we have just arrived at Horse of the Year show, and as you can see, it is super purpley and super pretty. It's all like the, oh look, it's the Hall of Fame skeleton. It's so pretty, and it's 9 a.m. so the shops have literally just opened and it is packed, as you can see. spin round the poly jumps course, which I think is technically for children, but we are the first time. And I was the most elegant show pony jumping round. And Danielle didn't do it, but peer pressure caved in. And she did it. And that was her first clear round. Been to A Touch of Silver and got myself a new necklace. I don't know if you can see, it's a guinea pig. There's just not enough guinea pig in jewellery these days. How cute is that? I'm now going to have a 5-minute break from shopping as our arms are aching with all the bags. Oh my god, I don't know what that is. And we're hoping to go catch the heavy horses. So, and then I think there's the minis as well, which is a bit of a strange one, going from the biggest horses to the smallest. And then 2 o'clock is Gymkhana, which is Danielle's favourite. Yeah. So we're going to go have a look. And it's very purpley and pretty down here. Super purpley. But this is the international arena where all the big boy stuff happens. And then there is another arena somewhere for the other showing classes, working hunter, etc.
Groups should be properly and smartly dressed.
How many horses are they going to be showing?
They should be ridden.
I'm sure it'll be the same here with this partnership. Once again, your champion, owned by Ruth Dowie, it is Interstar B.
Thank you.
Championship, which was very nice, very classy, and there was actually a very naughty Suffolk punch in there, which was quite funny, even though it shouldn't be funny, it was quite funny. And then it just said display on the timetable, and it was the musical ride done by the Pony Club.
Yeah,
and that was absolutely amazing.
Far better than the showing.
And yeah, there was like, how many was there? Like eight maybe or sometimes?
Ten?
A little Shetland, everyone getting involved, and it was like a magic theme, so that was so, so funny. And we're now going to do some more shopping and then come back later for Daniel's favourite.
Andy Games!
Andy Games! Games.
Charles and John, now looking for the final time. thanks to Julia and David Tottenham-Bones. They've been great supporters of Horse and Year Show for many, many years. So they have their own dome instead, which is in near Exham. So the Tottenham-Bones riding Horse of the Year, the reserve champion. Reserve, very well done to Hannah Horton. Hannah and Ellen Jenkins here for another prize. For the Tottenham-Bones riding Horse of the Year, I think I'm going to probably hear the dream from here. It's Leisha Lehmans, Kelly Thorpe's Obsession, and Fraser Atherton. Many congratulations, Fraser. Extremely well done to Fraser, and delighted to announce Riding Horse of the Year and to our champion, Kelly Thorpe's Obsession.
Joe's been training the West Hants for 18 years. This is Megan Pink and Sybil. Shall we cheer for Megan? Shall we cheer for the West Hants? Oh, guys! There you go. One, two, three, away we go. Hunt's going to jump in the plate. Brilliant turn. Who's it going to be? There's none in between them. As they come down, it's the Mamba. Is it the Mamba? Is it? It is the Mamba. Here we go. And Eglinton on double points Sunday for the Thistledown Developments Paddy Club Man against the Prince Philip Cup. You know what this is. The Penny Club Games started using the cavalry skills, the lance. This is the Penny Club's equivalent of the lance. They start with the balloons, they burst the balloons. I think the Monmouth's got a little bit unfair, Alan, just saying that the balloon is lying on the floor, but never mind. Here we go, we're under starter's orders. We're ready to go, he's gonna drop the flag and away we go. Back down it goes. They get the balloons, good shot. There's nothing between them as they take the turn and they're literally turning on the sixpence. Now it's the charge. West Hants in black, Eglinton have missed it. So now they've got to go. West Hants, Monmouth, Portland District. Up the top they go. Now they take the turn. This is brilliant racing this afternoon, I can promise you that much. Bang it goes. Great shot. They've all got the second. Now the West Hants are flying. They've got their mojo back. Here goes the West Hants and the Monmouth and the Portland District. There's nothing between these three teams. There's certainly not between the first and second. This is going to be close. This is going to be super close. Here comes the White Hat Man. And we are chasing. And we are chasing. And there's nothing. Oh my word, it's a penny club again. West Hants by a short bit. From District 1 to the Eglinton. Accuracy and speed. It's all about teamwork. Teamwork between the rider and the pony, the hop and the really on their turn. Go! Here we go. We're now racing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Who's going to be the first one over? It's the Eglinton down on the far side. And West Ham's just about held in the plate. Here goes the Monmouth right in the middle of the pack. Portland District. Look at the Eglinton. They are straight ahead. This is their favourite game. Now they go. Eglinton the second just away. And the West Ham's are now flying. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Did they get it? Yes, they did. There's nothing between them, and here comes the White Hat Man. Oh my word, this is racing like you can't believe it. Here are the horses of the air show. You can cheer them on. It's Scotland. 14 to the Monmouth, 9 apiece to the Eglinton and Portland District, 7 to the West Hats. 2 races left to go. This is the sack race. This is teamwork, and this is fabulous. You know this race. You're going to cheer. Because these kids, they have to be super fit. The ponies and the jockeys back behind the line. Now we go. And we're chasing. They are so fit. They are off the pony. They get off the pony, in the legs they go. Hold on to your pony. In goes one leg, in goes two legs, in goes three legs. And look at them go. Eglinton are away from Portland District. And this is brilliant. Look at West Hants are clueless. Oh, where does this other go? Have we got the other in? No! Not quite! Hold on! It's Eglinton! With the Archer guys!
Run and I can't even get my foot in the stirrup but it made me feel a little bit better when they fell over. Oh, maybe we're just slightly evil. but that was over and done in 20 minutes, 4 races, so it just gives you an idea how fast they were actually going. But some very cute ponies and making me feel like an old cripple.
Andrew Collins, Barnby Cullen ridden native Cobb traditional horse of the year. they put in the most amazing performance here this afternoon. Good form as well when they qualified at the Bath and West. 11.94, Red Rock the third. Victoria Hector, the colour with a native called Traditional Horse of the Year. But ladies and gentlemen, the Binks family, Show Hunter, Pony of the Year. We cast our minds back to earlier on in the summer. This combination qualified at the North of England. The champion, 1457, Whitecroft, Craig Hogan, and Phoebe Thomas, the winners of the 143 Show Hunter Pony of the Year, stand as our champions. To end their career together, it's been tremendous, but ladies and gentlemen, the Binks family, Show Hunter Pony of the Year, Whitecroft Beethoven and Phoebe Thomas. And all on their own, the champion, well done, Whitecroft Beethoven, Phoebe. To Timmis, Miss Muffet, and 1568, Rosemont to Dreamers, Kevin LaRue. That is the top 11 in catalogue order there for the Miniature Horse of the Year Championship.
Horse of the Year, and that was so cute. They're just so adorable. What I absolutely love about Hoys is it is like the pinnacle of people who have been showing all year. It's so hard to qualify for, and only the best get through. I mean, it really is sort of an amazing atmosphere. One day I would love to be here, but I think my horses would be very naughty. Your face says it all. We've had the most fantastic time and we've done loads of shopping. Thank you so much for watching this week's vlog. Please feel free to like, comment and subscribe. Bye!